What's up, people? My name is Mw3 Ffa, and I got a free-for-all on mission here for you guys today. And I'm using the Scar-L and the P90. And as you will see right here, I'm going to put a claymore right next to that truck. And this is a really good claymore spot for this map, because not only will the claymore blow up, but the truck is going to blow up as well. And that's going to equal like double, triple, quadruple damage on the guy. And we like that because it helps us get kills and it helps us get, you know, build our kill streaks and get Osprey gunners and juggernauts and stealth bombers, whatever it may be. So as you can see, I got killed by a camper, and what happens? Campers never win. Look at that. He got killed by some other guy, but eventually I take the other guy out as well. So it's a win-win. Everybody's happy. I mean, I don't know about that guy, but I'm definitely happy because I'm still alive. I'm still running around shooting people in the face, doing my thing. And now, just to touch upon the freaking perks, the perks that I'm using, man, they are so important because perks are the foundation to our society. Just kidding, but perks are important, so I'm going to touch upon them real quick. I'm using Sleight of Hand, Overkill, and Dead Silence. Now, Dead Silence is a given for free-for-all. It's really helpful, especially in these quiet game modes, such as free-for-all or Search and Destroy, because people really like to sound whore and listen to when people are sneaking up from behind them and all that great stuff. So, I mean, not only that, but it helps you hear other people's enemies. No, that makes no sense. It helps you hear other people's footsteps better because you're not hearing your own. Now, in terms of Overkill, let me just say this. It is so stupid when people use, like, Overkill and use, like, two of the same gun. Like, for example, people use Overkill and use two assault rifles. People use Overkill and use two submachine guns. People use Overkill and use two snipers. That's retarded. So don't do it. What I suggest you do is, I mean, this is kind of common sense, but make sure you pick a long-range weapon and a close-quarters weapon, because that really is how you utilize the perk to its full potential. That way you have something to kill people from long range, such as I have the Scar-L. And also you have something to kill people from close range, such as me when I'm using the P90. And this really helps. I mean, yeah, it really helps, especially in this map, which is Mission, and this map is kind of close quarters in the middle, yet on the edges and the corners, it is a little bit long range. So it's kind of a two-way street, kind of, you know, you could go either way, and that just goes along with the playstyle. I mean, if you're using a sniper, don't go in the middle. You know, you're supposed to stay on the outside. Try and keep your distance from enemies, but obviously with Overkill, it lets you adapt better to your surroundings, and it lets you be more of a versatile player. And the reason I'm using Sleight of Hand to go along with Overkill is because Sleight of Hand lets you switch your weapons faster, and that really helps when you're using Overkill, because obviously if I'm using a SCAR or an M16 and I have a USP to switch to, it's gonna take a lot faster than if I have to switch to a P90, such as what I'm doing right now. That's why when I have Sleight of Hand, it really lets you pull out your gun faster and use that second gun that you have. And that's really important because obviously if you can't switch from one gun to another really fast when you're using Overkill, it's really, there's no purpose to it, because what's going to end up happening is you're not going to want to switch to that second gun. And that's what I really found useful, is that even when I was in a tight spot and I just kind of assumed that there was an enemy around the corner, I was still able to pull out the gun before they came up and shot me. And that's the free-for-all right there. It's a 30-3 quick free-for-all. I have a bonus clip right now. And what this bonus clip is a search and destroy round where I got 4 kills, but that's not really the main thing. I mean, I was last alive in the end, but the main thing about this round is it's kind of cool how the last kill played out, because it was really all luck. And I don't know about you guys, but I hate when this happens to me, when I throw a flash at someone and I think I got them pinned down, but yet they just randomly shoot and get me. And that's exactly what happened to this unfortunate guy right here. Now, I'm going to get one more kill, get my UAV for the next round. And then after that, I decide to go underneath these stairs right here, because I know the bomb is upstairs, but I see him walk past the doorway. There he is. He walked past. So then after that, boom, I get flashed right in my face. You saw that happen right in my face, and yet I still shot and got lucky right there. That's just a little cool thing I had going on for me in the Search and Destroy game. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video as a whole. Please rate, comment, subscribe, and thanks so much for watching. Until next time.